Have you ever started a project? You knew exactly what you wanted to do. You had the best idea, but you had no clue on how to implement it? Yeah, it's happened to all of us. Organizing your game is hard. That's why in this video, I'll show you a good way to organize your tycoon using the component pattern, also known as composition. This is the same system I mentioned in another video, which I will link in the description. That video goes over the concept and like the higher level ideas, but in this video, we're going to be actually tackling some concrete system for this concept, which is our tycoon. So make sure to watch the previous video to get caught up on the progress we've made with our tycoon so far. And make sure to like this video if you enjoyed it and subscribe to my channel. And also join the Discord server. The link is in the description below. So without further ado, let's get started. So you might be thinking, the component pattern, why do I need that? Why can't I just write a normal game and make it work like a normal tycoon? And I thought the same thing. And then a few months later, I had a tycoon with a module script with over 1,000 lines of code. That was a very painful experience. So the component system aims to stop situations like that, where you take a system like a tycoon and you decouple it into a bunch of different snippets of code. So let's take a tycoon. It consists of buttons, droppers, conveyors, doors, walls, windows, etc. So if we were to make a script for each of those parts, it'll make our actual tycoon script very small, which is good for debugging, it's good for working with other people, and it's just good for general sanity. And I have a video going over composition or the component system in more detail, and I'll link it right now and in the description. Another benefit of using components is that you can mix and match them on any part or model you want, which will give you more flexibility and more code reuse throughout your entire project. Now that you know what the component pattern does and why we use it, it's time to figure out the how. How do we implement this into Roblox? Now, luckily, Roblox offers the collection service, which is a service that allows you to tag objects, and you can use those tags in your code to give them specific components, which is exactly what we want. I have a video on the collection service. If you don't know about it, I'll link it in the top right of your screen and the description. So the first thing you're going to do is make sure you have the tag editor plugin installed. So go to plugins, and then you should see tag window and worldview if you have it installed. I'll have a link to the install link in the description if you want to get it. And then I'm going to click on the tag window, bring up this little window, and now we can start tagging things. So I'm going to drag my template from server storage into the workspace. Let me just focus it. There we go. And then I'm going to create a part. So let me just plop a part down in the middle of this. And then we're going to like scale it, anchor it maybe. And then make sure to drag this part into the template model. And then once you've done that, we can now tag it. So I'm going to create a tag called test because our first component is going to be a test tag. So just type it in and press enter. It should appear here. And you'll notice there's a little tag list folder. I don't really know what this is for. It's for the plugin. So just don't touch it. Don't delete it. But now we can tag this part. So hover over the part, then click the test icon, and then click off. It should be tagged. In order to check that, go to plugins, then worldview, and it should have a different color. And if you hover over the color, it should say the tag it has. So it has the instance, like class name, the name of the instance, and then the tag, which is test, which is exactly what we want. So now the part is properly tagged. So now let's script our test component. I'm going to go into server script service and create a new folder. And this folder is going to be for all of our components, so I'm going to name it components. Inside of this folder, I'm going to create a new, I'm going to create a new module script and name this module script test because, you know, it's a test component. Just zoom in a little bit. Change module to test, and then we're going to set this up like a normal object-oriented class, very similar to our tycoon in the last video. So I'm going to say test dot underscore underscore index equals test. And we're going to do function test dot new, and whenever we create our components, it's going to get a reference to the tycoon that it was created by, and the instance, which could either be a part, a model, or whatever, is tagged that it has. And then we can define self as equal to set metatable blank table, and then test. And then we can just say return self. Now, in most of our components, we'll have self dot tycoon equals tycoon, and self dot instance equals instance. But honestly, that's only for ease of use for the functions down the line. So if you don't really use them, you don't need them, but I'll just leave them there as an example. Now let's make our test init function, because each component will have init and new. And new will be called, you can be just call it to create a new object, get access to all the functions or whatever. But for init, it'll actually do something. So in our case, doing something is just going to be printing test was initialized. I probably spelled that wrong, but whatever. So right now, this component does absolutely nothing. It's just a module script, never gets required, never gets used. So let's go into our tycoon module script and add functionality. So I first want to get the component folder at the top of our script. So I'm going to say local component folder equals script.parent.components. And we can use that down the line underneath our init and before the destroy. I always like to keep the destroy at the very end just so it makes a little more sense. We're going to make a function that is going to be tycoon create component. And it's going to be responsible just for making the components. It'll take in the instance that we want to create a component on and the component like module script. So we can just say component script that we want to use. And keep in mind, this script will not be required. It's just a little easier that way. So the first thing we want to do is say local comp module equals require component script. So they send in the actual like link or reference to the test like module, for example, but we have to require it to make sure we get the functions. And we can just say local new component, or just new comp, equals comp module dot new. And then keep in mind, we want to send in a reference to the tycoon to our test component. So we have to use self, because we're running this function inside of tycoon itself, so we need to give it a reference to the tycoon that's calling it, which in this case is self. Pretty simple. And then we also want to send you the instance, which is given to us generously by the parameter. And then we can init the new comp by saying new comp init. And this function may seem a little pointless on its own, but trust me, we'll use it down the line, so just leave it there. And this function will be used by tycoon add components, which is another function that I'm defining right now. And it'll take in an instance. So this function is going to be pretty cool. It'll run through all the tags of our instance and then add all the necessary components. And in order to like run through the tags to like play with them, you have to get the collection service. So I'm going to go to the top of my script and define local collection service equals game get service collection service. There we go. So now we can use all of our collection service stuff. And let's go down here and say for underscore tag in ipairs collection service get tags. Make sure to use get tags and not get tagged, because get tagged just gets all the tag things for a certain string tag. But we want to get all the tags of our instance, because one of the main benefits of using the component system is that multiple things or multiple components can be added to a single instance. And that's why we want to get all the tags on our instance. And then we'll have a do at the very end. And then here we go. So let me just explain this part. Underscore just means we're never going to use this value, if you're wondering about that. And then we're using ipairs because this returns an array. And it's always good practice to use ipairs with an array and not just a dictionary. And so now in our for body, we can define the component as being equal to components folder find first child of tag. So what this will do, I spelled this wrong, component folder, there we go. What this will do is it'll find the component based off the tag if it exists. If it doesn't exist, it'll return down. And you may be asking, why can't we just assume all of the tags are equal to all of the components? In a complex game, you might accidentally add another tag that you weren't meaning to, or there could just be extra tags that do different things, or you could be working with other people that add tags without you knowing, and it could break your game. So this is just a safer approach where you check if the component exists, which we'll do right now by saying if component, then we can do self create component off the instance that we have and the component like script that we've got, and it'll just create all the components. So as a test, we can go up to our init, and underneath the self.model, we can just say self add components based off of self.model.part. So we're going to add all the components for the little test part that we created, which is under self.model.part, which is like over here. And now make sure before you test this to put the template back into server storage. I don't really know what happened here, but now we should be able to run it and everything should work. So you can see at the bottom of the screen, it says test was initialized, and that's perfect because when we ran the code, the add components was called, it looked through all of the test components, and then it created the test component, and it was initialized, and then it printed it out. So that's exactly what we want. Now the system can be expanded to any number of components you want on any number of parts, and each part can have any number of components as well, which is really good, really expandable. So that's it for this video. I knew the past two videos have been a lot of nitty-gritty stuff, just getting set up, implemented. But trust me, in the next video, we'll be getting started with some actual tycoon and meat, where we'll be making components that can be unlocked, and potentially even creating the infamous tycoon button that you press to unlock new things. So stay tuned for that. And other than that, subscribe to my channel if you enjoyed this video, and make sure to like the video, comment any of your questions and suggestions down below, and also the code will be in the description if you need some help. It's in a little GitHub repository with all the videos, so that's pretty convenient. But other than that, I hope you have a nice day, and goodbye.